We're in Novak. How clever of them. Novak. So funny and clever. Obviously, I'm being sarcastic. What am I supposed to do here? Ask around Novak. Well, let's go to the robot that was in Good Springs.
Well, butter my butt and call me a biscuit if it ain't my old friend from Good Springs. Don't rightly know. I just got the notion to make my way to New Vegas. Reckon I'll find out when I get there. Novak? Nice enough place, I suppose. But between you and me, when I rolled into town, my skin started to itch. Watch yourself.
All right.
No, don't believe I did. But you might ask around. The Novak folk usually see anyone traveling this way.
Pretty sure he did say that, though, so...
Likewise, friend, likewise. Is there anything old Vic can do you for? Well, this ain't New Vegas, but I reckon you can find what you need here. Try the office out front.
Alright.
Be seeing you.
Yeah, I don't trust you, Victor. With your cowboy hat and your cigarette and your bandana and your overly expressive eyebrows. I don't see nobody there. Ada, you scumbag. What is this? Ranger Andy? Probably in here. Dinky the T-Rex.
Well, welcome to you. You look tired from the road. Why don't you relax a spell? Let this fine town take care of you. Oh, what am I doing? I got to thinking about making a good impression and plain forgot to tell you my name. I'm Jeannie May. I take care of folks here at the motel, long as they aren't troublemakers.
Great.
Well, he might have been wearing a fancy outfit, but he wasn't any kind of gentleman to me. Had his nose stuck so high in the air you couldn't see it above the clouds. City folk, they always think they deserve better than what they got. Those hoodlums he was with seemed to know Manny for some reason. He's our daytime sniper up in the dinosaur's mouth.
All right.
We're in a little desert oasis, name of Novak. This is the Dino Delight Motel, and it's mine. Go see Cliff Briscoe at the Dino Bite gift shop, and tell him I sent you. I think he gets lonely standing around in that dino belly all day. He'll be glad for the company.
Sure thing.
I think that's a fine idea. I'll give you a good flat rate, and you can stay as long as you like. At least until the busy season comes. Sound good?
Yeah.
I'm glad you can stay with us. Your room will be the one upstairs, closest to the lobby side. Here's your key. Let me know if there's anything I can do to make your stay better for you. Watch out.
Now I gotta go find my room, wherever that's at. Did you say first one on the left upstairs? Yep. Why does he just slide off the couch? Dude, sit down. Sit down. Are you kidding me, dude? Sit down on the couch, bro. Alright, get on the table then. I guess that I can just... This is my place now. I don't want to start storing stuff just in case it's not actually my place. I guess I'm just gonna lay down. All right, I'm leaving. Dinosaur. How do I get in there? Oh. The Dino Bite gift shop. Turn that off. Yeah, I'm already in here, dude, so... You saying that means nothing. Wash R? Wash R? Okay. Dinky. Who are you?
Welcome to the Dino Bite gift shop. My name's Cliff. If you're here for the T-Rex figurines, you're just in time. There's still a few left.
Bro looked like, Obama.
Bless her. Seems like every traveler I get in here tells me the same thing. They see the sign and think, gift shop? That's just too good to be true. But Jeannie Mae always points them back in my direction. Well, a friend of Jeannie's is a friend of mine, and my friends get a discount at my store. Well, there's T-Rex figurines, of course. That's our bread and butter. We also have an assortment of the Repcon factory souvenirs, rockets, things of that nature. They're scale replicas of the real thing. Very detailed. Got a liquid in them that makes them glow. From what I hear, Repcon used to give them out on tours of their HQ up in Henderson. But I guess they had to stop after the first few kids thought they were filled with Nuka-Cola and drank it down. The papers had a name for the condition and everything. They called it the Repcon Shakes. Those were bad times for Robco.
I bet they were.
Well, they unloaded what they had left on the Dino Bite as a tax write-off, but that was before my time. Plenty of demand for them, seeing as how they're one-of-a-kind collector's items, but I might still have some in back. Guns? I guess I might have a few. Darn it, no one ever buys the T-Rexes.
I'm actually very interested in the T-Rexes.
Have a look.
Not gonna lie to you. Caravan shotgun sounds pretty good. I got a message saying Fallout, huh? I was just checking my audio, that's why I haven't, Yeah, I'm checking the audio. It's glitching out for me. Sounds as good as it's gonna sound. I don't really know why it buzzes. It's always done that. That's really ew. What the? Like SpongeBob chewing on a mouse trap? That gun? The F is that? I would like the Power Fist. But not for $200. Dinky the T-Rex, where is that? $1,000 value? It weighs 100 pounds? Okay, yeah, I'm gonna have to wait till I get a house before I carry something like that around in my pocket. I definitely want it, and I'll get the rocket souvenir. That's all I'm gonna get from you.
Come back soon now.
No.
What's going on, man?
Yeah.
Sure, I know him. What do you want with him? Doesn't surprise me. Guy seemed like he'd do whatever it takes to get what he wants. Probably makes a lot of enemies. Well, listen, I can definitely help you find him, but I've got problems of my own. Maybe we can do a trade. You need my help. There's something I need, too. Novak, it's home for me now. I want that to be for good. I like it here, and I've left too many homes behind. But the only resource we got here is junk. Without that, people wouldn't have anything to trade. They'd all have to leave. We get most of it up the road from the old rocket test site, but a bunch of ghouls showed up one day and took it over. We can't get in there now. Well, they gotta go, or this'll be a ghost town before long. Doesn't matter to me what you do. As long as the ghouls are out of there, that's good enough for me. It'd mean a lot to me.
About the buzzing, I don't understand why it buzzes, because I thought it was my mic doing it, but if I unplug my mic, it still makes the buzzing noise. So it's probably just my Xbox. What am I supposed to do? Mailbox. The McBride House. Well, hello, Nathaniel's mom. Okay. Wait a minute. Does he supposed to be working today? Yeah. This is 100% mine territory right here. No? It's where I would put mines. Here is an ash pile. Holy ball bag. Crazy damage, man, the rebar. Jet medics. Look at a phone right there. Pressure cooker. Right now I'm hitting him with a baton. Yeah, those look like ghouls to me. Come on over here. Yeah, they're just regular old ghouls, just like every other Fallout game. They're not worth searching. I thought I was being clever there. I thought he would run into me while I was doing the power attack. It did not work. So now we gotta clear this place of ghouly heads. Not good.
Hey! Over here! Are you listening? Go to the big room on the east side of this building and take the metal staircase all the way up. And hurry. Let's hope you do.
Didn't hear nothing he said, wasn't paying a nightkin. Yeah, he's like a blue super mutant. What's that all about? Oh my god, yeah, the Pip-Boy lighting is so bad. I may even just turn brightness up just because, like, I can't take it anymore. Come here. Oh, dang. Another dead ghoul. And they're like Brotherhood ghouls. But the Brotherhood hates ghouls. Unless this brotherhood doesn't, but... I really don't know... if I want to turn the brightness back down, or I probably will, because it's probably going to be too bright outside now. We'll just leave it at that. This, like, it almost doesn't even help to use the Pip-Boy. Yeah, it's like, it's almost worse to have the Pip-Boy light on. Come on up here. Get your cheeks busted. Hang on, before I talk to you, I picked up a bunch of stuff. The Rebar Club, absolutely leveling that up. Not leveling it up, repairing it. Alright, there we go.
Alright, Smoothskin. I'm letting you in. You better watch yourself. I'll sure as hell be watching you.
I'm gonna turn them up, the voices, because...
God, but are you ugly? Get upstairs and talk to Jason before I throw up just from looking at you. Your pranks won't work on me, Smoothskin. They won't work on Jason either. Stop wasting my time, Smoothskin. Go waste Jason's.
You know, I could barely see your face, dude. Yeah, you're definitely not a ghoul.
Journey? You're referring to Chris. I doubt you had much luck if you tried telling him that he's human. We had the same discussions when he first appeared, and the same lack of success. He believes he is one of us. Soon enough, we realized that Chris was a gift from the Creator. He is integral to the success of the Great Journey.
Okay, dude.
I am Jason Bright, the prophet of the Great Journey. All the ghouls you see here are members of my flock. The demons appeared from nowhere, except it might be more accurate to say they never actually appeared at all. The demons are invisible. Where one of them stands, the most one sees is the air shimmering like sunlight on water. They set upon us as we were on our way to worship one morning. We had just entered the basement. My flock fought bravely and killed a few, but at such cost. Nearly half of us died or went missing. The rest of us retreated up here. One of the demons raved at us, but they have not tried to attack us since. Still, their demonic presence brought all progress towards the great journey to a standstill. But now you have come. Once again, the Creator has sent a human to help us across a seemingly insurmountable obstacle. Yes, over the intercom. Threats of death should we step outside. Guarantees of safety should we stay locked away. It went on for hours and did not always make sense. But that was the first day only. Since then, silence. Will you drive away the demons, Wanderer? But we have no hope of completing the great journey without your help.
Do I have to help these people?
The Creator's divine will.
Hello.
Return. Will you help us, Wanderer? We wish to escape the barbarity of the wasteland, especially the violence and bigotry of its human inhabitants. The Creator has promised to my flock a new land, a place of safety and healing, a paradise in the far beyond. Preparations for the great journey were nearly complete when the demons appeared. The means by which the great journey is to be accomplished are an article of faith. Not to be discussed with outsiders.
Okay, bro.
I have glimpsed it only in visions, Wanderer, but what I have seen is truly miraculous. It is a place of light and healing, and I know in my soul that my flock will be safe there. Yes, Wanderer?
Go bother Jason, Smoothskin. I don't like having you around. Stay away from me.
Will you help us, Wanderer? An auspicious name, don't you think? It was mine before I became as I am now. Before the Great War, even. Truly does the Creator author a destiny for each and every one of us.
See, he's basically like a cult guy, you know, so I'm gonna try what I think might work. And that would be to save the game. And then try to kill him. He had nothing on him. Dodged me somehow. Brotherhood robe. Okay, so they're not the Brotherhood of Steel. You know what? I guess I'll do their stupid mission.
Will you help us, Wanderer? Yes.
Yep.
Praise the as soon as the underground has been rid of demons, preparations for the great journey can resume.
I'm sure they can, dude. I'm sure they can. Now I gotta go to the basement and get my cheeks clapped. Is this the basement? Probably down here. There we go. Turbo plus one, what does it even mean?
Gotcha. says, you are the one killing my kin. Antler says, you must die.
Okay. That was real close right there. Yeah, I don't really know why you would come down here. I'm gonna go ahead and save it. My health is way too low. Forgot. I may be able to just teleport though if I go back out. Dude, that is somehow worse than the almost broken, like, knives and stuff.
Is the way clear? Praise the Creator and bless you, Wanderer. The way is clear. I will lead my flock through the basement to the sacred site. I hope you will come find us there, Wanderer. There is much to be done.
No beds to. Okay, there they are. I need to heal, so. Didn't really expect him to go all the way down here, but yeah.
I waited to speak with you one last time before I descended to the launch pad, Wanderer. I want you to know that we will remember for all eternity how you delivered us to the threshold of the Great Journey. Our preparations are nearly complete, but the rockets that will carry us to salvation are yet missing vital components. If you would still help us, Wanderer, speak to Chris. He can tell you what is missing. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always. Yes, the rockets will convey us to our promised land in the far beyond. Vision upon vision has confirmed it. I understand your concerns, friend, and I thank you for voicing them. But the Creator's will for us has been made manifest. After all that you have done for us, I suppose you deserve to know everything. When Chris came to us, we tried to convince him that he was human. But this only angered him. He seemed lost. We decided to let him stay with us for a few days, over the course of which we learned that his technical skills far surpassed our own. It became clear that the Creator had sent him to us to ensure the success of the Great Journey. Equally clear was that Chris should labor in blessed ignorance of his humanity and his inability to make the journey himself. It is no coincidence that two humans have been vital to the success of the Great Journey. It is my belief that the Creator sent you and Chris to expiate the sins of your kind against mine. Your redeemers both. Such is the Creator's will. Vision upon vision has shown me that were Chris to accompany us, he would die in minutes. The radiation around the launch pad alone would kill Chris in minutes. The radioactivity of the far beyond is much stronger. It is the Creator's will, and I must submit. There is no malice in it. We would take him with us if we could. There is no way that we can thank you enough, Wanderer. Your arrival here was a blessing. We will remember you always.
Alright, yeah, these guys are crackheads.
Hey, Jason says that I am to cooperate with you on the final tasks necessary to launch the Great Journey.
Alright.
I was close to completing work on the rockets before we were driven into hiding on the top floor. Two components were missing. A quantity of isotope 239 igniting agent, and a set of thrust control modules. The igniting agent is highly radioactive and decays quickly. That's why we can't use the drums that leak down on the launch pad. It's no longer potent enough. I need you to find an intact, shielded container of the igniting agent. As for the thrust control modules, they were custom built for these rockets. They won't even launch without them. Very well. We don't need a huge amount. 2 to 3 liters should be enough. Let me see. Yes, that's the igniting agent. But we'll need more of these souvenirs. A total of 5 should do it.
Okay, great.
Repcon has been ransacked so many times by scavengers, it's hard to know where the components might turn up, if they turn up. Jason has mentioned some industrial ruins to the east that are supposed to be highly radioactive. All right, what would you rather be doing? All right, anything else?
I need to look at the map and see where that might take me. Can I fast travel inside? No, okay. I just thought I'd check. Didn't think so, but... you know. Maybe that dude will, tell me where to go now, though. Definitely fast traveling. Ew, look at a homeless guy. What is it? Homeless woman? What is this? Oh no, that's Jeannie. Yikesies. Dumb igniting agent. It's like a junkyard.
Gibson, or so they tell me. I've got odds and ends for sale, and I'm pretty good at fixing things, too. You might have noticed the very large building just north of here. That's Helios 1. The NCR runs the place, so it's off limits to prospectors. As it so happens, I do have some thrust modules, but they're expensive. 500 caps worth of expensive.
That's so bad. Maybe you and I could work out some kind of trade.
I know I'm not young and pretty anymore, but I appreciate the thought all the same. Here, take the parts, you flatterer. So, you're back. Certainly did. Hubby and me had an old rad meter to help us tell the difference between what you could salvage and what'd kill you. I kept a glowing container from Repcon around here for years, serving no better purpose than a nightlight. Damn thing wouldn't sell. Then along comes the most peculiar-looking fellow, all decked out in a yellow radiation suit, of which he was proud all out of proportion. The man outright asked if I had anything radioactive for sale. Imagine that. But he paid handsome for that jar of goop. Only saw him that once. He said something about heading over to Clark Field to put his suit through its paces. A strange one he was. Happy to do it.
Cool that there's little mods you can get.
Well, I'll give you a hint. They used to just call me Gibson. I hope you can figure out the rest. I don't mind, to be honest. Living long is a real accomplishment these days. Remains to be seen if I end up dying peaceful in my bed. Take care now.
Why did it put me all the way down here? Oh, okay, because the little basement thing.
We discussed. Indeed you did, and they seem to be in excellent condition. All I need now is the igniting agent we discussed earlier. Later.
Just find the atomic fuel, bro. No problem. Ew, a little gecko. Yeah, come here. It's kind of sad when they, you know, they hold their head like that. Oh, it's that guy with the radiation suit. I wanted to see if I could break his face off. My cowboy hat's broke. No. And that was pretty easy. And I didn't even really have to give him my rocket either. Yeah, for some reason I thought they were Brotherhood of Steel, but they're not. They're just regular. Just Brotherhood. There you go.
Components we discussed. Yes, that's the stuff. And the container shielding must be intact, or you'd be dead by now. Yes, I'll tell Jason that the great journey can begin.
They're instantly gonna die, dude. Every single one of them.
Everything we need to launch the rockets, Jason. The great journey can begin.
I'm gonna save real quick.
Gather all. May the Creator guide my words and help me speak true. The Almighty Creator has seen fit to answer our prayers. The time has come for us to board the rockets and begin the great journey. Though it may seem that all humans despise us, the Creator has seen fit to instruct us differently. The journey ahead would have been impossible if not for the intercession of two human friends, one new, the other a long-abiding companion.
Hello.
To our new friend, we say thanks and promise never to forget how we cleared from our path the demons who sought to stay our journey. But to Chris, we owe more than thanks. Chris, you have made this great journey a reality. From this moment forward, you will be remembered as the saint of the great journey. We shall never forget you. I ask that you forgive us, Chris, and give us your blessing. And we bestow ours upon you. Seekers, board the rockets. Take your seat.
Look at their gross little helmets. This reminds me of in Fallout 4 when they got in that UFO and everybody's head blew up. I didn't know that I had to do anything. I had to stand there watching. But apparently there's a viewing platform and I have to launch them. So great. I like that I get to keep the hat even though it's broken. Yeah, I'm gonna have to go outside, ain't I? Yep. Not really outside. Probably. I don't know. They're definitely gonna die or crash. They're probably gonna crash. Is it in here? Yep. Through here too. Okay. Wait a minute. Should I have done the navigation controls? Hold on, let me reload. Because I didn't even think to use the navigation controls. Mash on the keys. Okay. Yeah, they're dead for sure. Maybe if we had higher intelligence, but my character is really stupid, so they're definitely dying. Oh. Novak, enough news of your good works has been passed around that people like you. People like me and Novak. Be real, I'm surprised they didn't blow up. Got a lot more perks now. Bloody mess. Ferocious loyalty. More caps. Lead belly. Toughness. So it's either going to be bloody mess or toughness. This is like, helps with, like, I'll do this one. Let me out of here. Only you can prevent corporate espionage. This is gonna be annoying trying to find my way out of this building. Yeah, I might as well just go down to the basement. Take the long way out of here. It's not the right way. Here we are. No, I've never been here, so. Stealth Boy shipment. I don't understand why I'm struggling so hard to find the way out. I mean, I knew where it was not too long ago. I can't stand when this stuff happens, man. It's just super confusing sometimes. Yeah, I've been here, been in all these rooms, this ain't it. I know I went down here. This wasn't it. Yeah, that's not it. I guess I'll go through here again. Yep, this is it. See, I don't know why. I walked past that like 4 times. I don't know what's wrong with me. True pain. Go back to Novak.
Who sent you? I ain't talking. They tried to get me to talk before, but I didn't say nothing. And I don't aim to now, by gum. We'll just see about that. You come any closer, and I'm liable to stick you with my sticking knife. Old Stick is feeling mighty ornery this day. You sure now? It's kind of hard to hear you. Okay, okay, just speak up a little. But not so much that they hear you. They got people everywhere, always listening.
Who?
Because they know I ain't just barking here. What I say has got bite. Because it's the truth. Them quack doctors can say what they want about all the rad scorpion stings that done pierced my skull, and I know what I seen. There's been things of a disturbing nature going on at the McBride Corral. Seems every night one of their herd meets a most unnatural death, and always there's holes all over the body. Work of the chupacabra, the livestock vampire, says Nobark, but they don't pay no mind. Too many holes, they say, and there's bullets in them. Well, says Nobark, we got a chupacabra with an automatic weapon. And that's when they get real quiet, because now they see the predicament we're in.
Yeah, man, chupacabra with automatic weapon, that's, yeah.
I come face to face with the chupacabra himself one night, whilst I was investigating whether this gecko was hiding his treasure from me. He was the meanest, ugliest chupacabra you could imagine. Had two heads and fangs down to the ground. Best I could tell, anyways, since when he come up to me, he was invisible. Had himself a blunderbuss, what would rotate and shoot bullets real fast out of a backpack. Never seen nothing like it. Walked right past me having an argument with somebody. But I only saw one chupacabra, so I guess the other fella had to be invisible too. Only more invisible than the other one. Folks will tell you that they seen ghouls up near the rocket factory. Sensationalist hooey, cooked up by superstitious yokels, seeing phantoms of their own imagining. Ghosts. Commie ghosts, but don't know they're dead. Hoping to steal our rockets. They can fly up and paint the moon pink and draw a Lenin face on it. I seen one of them disappear and reappear before my very eyes. Although, being a scientist, I have to admit I might have just blinked for longer than usual, what with the shock of seeing a commie ghost and so forth. If anyone asks, we never spoke.
Yeah, he's smoking crack. For sure. I don't trust Victor at all.
Hey there. You have any luck with the ghouls? I'm counting on you. Really? Unbelievable, man. I knew that wasn't gonna be easy. But I had a good feeling about you. You look like you've been through a lot. Okay, I'll tell you everything I know, like I promised. The guy you're looking for, Benny, he was traveling with some members from my old gang. They were going to Boulder City. No clue. I know Benny hadn't paid up yet. Maybe that was where they were supposed to get square. It's straight up Route 93 from here. Just keep following the road north. Hope that helps. I owed you.
Yeah, you did.
Yeah, see ya.
I'm idolized. Idolized by the community. Boulder City. Alright, we'll get headed that way. But we'll do it. The next time. Uh-oh.